check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.
Hello, welcome to my channel. I'm Kudret. Today we have a new device from the Inokin Chroma R. It is a couple of months ago it was on the market. I just got it now. I bought it myself. And here I have a stainless steel version. Up here there's a 4 different color. I think I will put on the here somewhere. It is a really nice color. I really like them. If you look at the in the box here, we can see our mode. And then I have normally they sell with the kit version also like an MTL kit this one, but I just have a mod here, not the MTL kit. There is a one USB charging cable of this one, and then there is a one warranty and safety card here. You can read it for your battery safe and everything. Then and then is there is a one user manual, German and English of inside there. If you look at the R mode here. I can take the battery out first. Yeah. And this is the mod here. Like I say, there's a steel version up here. There. On the side, you see Chroma R, and on the other side, Inokin. On the front, there's a screen and power button, as you see here. It is really nice power button, up and down button, and then USB charging port up there. There's a up to 26 watts. 26 millimeter, it is fit, all atomizer. As you see here, I put GT4 on that. Not a problem at all. 26 millimeter, it's perfectly fitting there. Also, you can use like a for MTL, your MTL atomizer on this one. As you see here, I will put some MTL otter here. That's from Greece. As you see here, it just doesn't look bad at all. It's nice. This is 22 millimeter. I will leave on that one here. On the behind here, some kind of rubber or something. It is really nice feeling. Even when you are holding and everything, it is really nice feeling on this one. And under it, as you see it here, it is really shiny up here. It is almost you scared to touch it with it because of the fingerprint and everything. But there is an on the side, it not a problem like that. I don't have any problem or anything. There's a battery door here. It is really nice and strong. I don't have any problem with it. I will put some 18650 on here, and then we can close it. No problem at all. Yeah, it's on the body. It is really look nice. I love the look like this mods. Here is our screen. 3-click power on. As you see here, Inokin. And then if he's asking me if it is same one, yes. And then there is a one lock here. It's green now. You can lock the your wattage and our battery there. Here, a wattage and then how many seconds in ohm and a puff counter and voltage here. If you press the down button and the power button in the same time, as you see here, it's turning red now. Then you cannot change any wattage here. If you press it again, as you see it, if I press the up and power button in the same time. As you see here, is giving us batteries, how many volts in there, and a puff counter clear or back, and our ohmage here, and I say back to there. And if when you want to change the wattage up here, up and down button, one of them, if you press a little bit here, keep pressing, and then you see blinking there, and then you can change it up to 80 watts, really fast. And there is a roundabout from the 6 watts. I leave it on the 11 watts. If you press the up and down button in the same time, as you see, we come in the menu. You see the wattage menu already and a watt mode. You see here salt, normal, and a hard. I say back, and there's a voltage mode, as you see here, voltage mode. If you press again, it's same, it's going up to, yeah, you see 7.5. 7.50 here, and there is also round robin. If I press up and down button same time again, there is again volt modes, soft, normal, hard, and back. There's a curve mode. I'm not gonna go in there. It's complicated. Most of the people, when they know or they don't know, is thinking too much like that, and they don't know what to do. That's why I'm not gonna show that. Bypass mode is also like a mechanical mode. Is a cut off here. When you press cut off here, it's like a 6 seconds, 7 seconds, like this, and then you can cut it like that. And then when you're pressing firing, after 8 seconds later, it will turn it off. It's like I saying cut off power. And then there is one screen saying here is also 7 seconds. After 7 seconds later, screen will be turning off, not off, like a light will go off from it. And then that's it. The menu system doesn't look that bad at all. I really love how it is looking, this one, especially on the screen here, and a really nice power button up here. I don't have any problem with it. Let's wave and then we will talk about it more. Yeah, that was the Inokin Chroma R, as you see here. I'm using with the Typhoon GT4 here, single coil, as you see. I'm getting 0.25 ohm, 3.75 volts. I'm only using on the volt modes. Let's wave. Yeah, firing is really good. I don't have any problem with it. It is really look nice mod here, especially with the silver atomizer and everything. Doesn't matter with the single atomizer or MTL users, they are all look nice. I think look sexy this mod. You see like a 3-4 different color options also. They're also nice, and I love with the matte black. Hopefully I will get another one black version as well. And then this is really nice. Yeah, I don't have any complaining about the mod. It is really nice, but of course it's a little bit also depend on you, how you're gonna use it. It's like a, are you gonna use like a MTL user or MTL, or like a single coil or dual coil atomizer or sub ohm tank. For MTL and single or sub ohm tank, like a 50 to 60 watts, it will be okay. But over that, I wish they can add like a some kind of like a 21700 battery. But it's like I said, of course, it's like it depends on the how you want, how you're gonna use this mod. If you are using like a Typhoon GT4, like a, or single atomizer like this on this one, you don't have any problem with it. Or MTL users, no problem. Sub ohm tank, no problem. But dual coil is not gonna last your battery life all day long, like a say like a 6570 with the 18650. I wish they did like a 21700, but then it will be get bigger and then little bit heavier, of course. But it is not like this. It is really nice and handy, small. Of course, I have a little bit big hand, but I don't have any problem with that. Especially in the summer is coming now, we need it like this. New mod wise is couple of months on the market, but it is really nice looking on the black on the back, and then black on the front. It is really nice with the silver atomizer. I don't have any problem. I can recommend it all of you, not a problem. There is no fingerprint or something. Most of the like this mods, couple of times like a sweating on the hand, and especially summertime, and a fingerprint on the mods and everything. I don't have any problem with it. I wish they did like a 21700, like I say, depends on you. On the rest, I don't have any problem with it, firing or anything. Quality is really nice. I can say all this to you. That's it, I think, for this today. Thank you very much for watching me. Have a nice day. Take care of yourself.